Now the last thing is that now we have three variables instead of x and y. Now we have three variables. So let me show you in the file. So if I open a file, so these are three files. So in these three files, in the first file, we have the relationship between P2 and P3 when P1 is 1. In the second file, we have a relationship between variables P2 and P3 when P1 is 2. And in the third, when P1 is 3. So if I open this file, as you can see that we have a relationship between P2 and P3, but P1 is 1 for all these values. So we could have taken P1 in the third column and put all 1 values, but there is no need to do that because we know P1 is 1 for all this. So we can plot these three variables and we will get, of course, three plots, three lines between P2 and P3. One is when P1 is 1, one is for P1 equals 2 and 3. So how to deal with this situation? So it is very simple. Just like our first example in which we used one file, if you look at here, this was the first example. So I will just copy this from this, only this text picture area to keep things simple. I just copy this and I place it here at the end. Now in the title, I want to put something different here. For example, I want to put par and then P1. So P underscore 1 will be printed in the subscript. For P1 equals 1, 2, and 3. And then I close the curly braces because this I have to put as one value. So therefore I am putting these curly braces because all these three are the keys for this axis environment. So therefore I'm putting these curly braces here. So my title is for P1 equals 1, 2, and 3, I'm plotting the values of P2 and P3. So my X label is P2, P underscore 2, and my Y label is P3. And now I am getting value from a file. So I have to put this table keyword and I'm not putting any color here. I can totally remove this. And the first file, my first file is, the name was P1 is 1. So P1 underscore is underscore 1 dot txt. This was my first file. And then I can just copy this, add plot two more times. With P1 is 2, because these are the names of my files. P1 is 1, P1 is 2 and 3. And now I am ready to plot. So it is very simple. And here is our plot. So as you can see that how simply you can plot in LaTeX. You have three files, data is in those files. And with just few lines of code, you can get a wonderful plot. You don't have to put any image. This is a real plot in LaTeX. And this will match exactly with your text. So these are your plots. So let's say that I want to put a legend of these three values. So how to do that? So inside this axis environment, you can also put a grid if you want. For example, grid. You just put grid equals, let's say major grid. And then you can put legends. So the key for legend is legend entries. Legend entries, this is the key. So this package provides you a lot of keys. And this is the thing you have to learn. How to use these keys, where to use these keys, what are the options for these keys. So legend entries is the key which we are using. And in this, we have to put what are the legends. For example, P1 equals 1, P1 equals 2, and P1 equals 3. These are the three graphs. So we can put like in the dollar sign, three pair of dollar signs and comma in between. and then we can simply say p1 equals 1. So p underscore 1 equals 1. And in the next pair of dollar sign, we say p underscore 1 equals 2. And p underscore 1 equals 3. So these are our three graphs. So these are our three legend entries. So if I compile now, and now as you can see that we have legends here. But now the problem is that these legend entries are covering the one of the graphs. So we don't want them. We want to move them either here or in this corner. So this is the southeast corner. This corner is southeast, east and down. So this is southeast. So we have an option of position of southeast for this. So how to use that? So after this legend entries, we say legend pos means position equals southeast and a comma. And now if I compile and a comma here as well, because this is the next entry. And now if I compile, and now you can see that our legend entries are at southeast corner. So this was it for this video. I hope that you find this video useful.